Hello, today we are going to see hydraulic systems and basically the comparison between pneumatic system components and hydraulic system components. So it's under mechanical design and analysis. We have already seen pneumatic components. There is a separate video for that where I have discussed what are the components of a pneumatic system. Similarly, there will be an article about hydraulic system components. So instead of studying them individually, today we are going to see them side by side sort of comparison. So let me make a quick chart here. First, I will write the pneumatic system components. Basically, we are going to see the difference between pneumatic and hydraulic systems. What are the components? What are the characteristics? And which will help you in making a selection of a circuit and appropriate components when you are designing that kind of system. And the first and most important concept here is the working medium. The working medium in pneumatic is compressed air, whereas in hydraulic, I will not call it as compressed oil because when you say the word compressed, it gives you a false indication that somehow you can change and reduce the volume. Oil being a liquid, the reduction in volume at higher pressure is negligible. So I will just call it as oil under pressure. And because of this working medium, in case of the energy supplier, in pneumatic will be through compressor, and here it will be pump. Pneumatic systems, we have cylinders, and this can be single acting. That means it will have only one port. So whenever you supply compressed air, the piston will expand, and in order to return that cylinder piston back, there will be a spring. But basically, there will be only one port, and the air will be released to the atmosphere. It can also be a double acting, where you have two separate ports, and you can apply pressure at any of the port to have forward as well as return motion. In case of hydraulic circuits, well, we cannot afford to release the oil to the atmosphere. So by default, everything will be double acting. There is no such thing called single acting hydraulic cylinders. The next thing will be certain components will be present in pneumatic systems and which will not be required at all for hydraulic system. For example, let's take the component lubricator. In pneumatic system, you filter out the air from dust and moisture. In that process, it becomes very dry and it cannot reach all parts of the circuit. So we insert drops of oil into that compressed air so that the air will become smooth and it will reach all part of the circuit. The energy consumption will be less. In case of hydraulic circuit, since the working medium is already oil, there is no such thing called lubricator. In the terms of pressure developed, here for pneumatic system, it will be around 6 to 8 bar. We can go as high as up to 12 bars also. Hydraulic systems are in the range of 50 to 60 bar. I will say max approximately 12 bars. And compared to that, the hydraulic systems can go up to 400 bars also. The load carrying capacity, or the force generated in case of pneumatic system, will be comparatively small, and here it will be higher. Now, in terms of operating speed, the pneumatic systems are very fast compared to hydraulic systems, which are normally slow. Their operating speed is considerably smaller as compared to pneumatic systems. Another term will be for comparison will be accuracy. Now, here is the thing. Compressed air, being a gas, undergoes significant amount of changes in volume, and the volume is slightly unpredictable, not repeatable. So if you are using pneumatic system for measurement of something, or where accuracy is very important, then pneumatic systems will be a little bit bad in terms of accuracy. Compressed oil, being a liquid, does not have too much volume changes. So here the accuracy will be a little bit higher. Why this comparison is important? Because when you are designing a system for your project, senior year project, or your final year project, and you have an option, you have a choice of going for pneumatic actuators, pneumatic system versus hydraulic systems. These are the parameters you are going to compare, and you are going to make a selection. Another criteria, and which is really a significant criteria, is pneumatic systems being operated by atmospheric air, the leakage problems are almost not there. And even if air leaks through the pipes and tubes, it does not cause any significant damage, other than the fact it does have some drops of oil introduced by lubricator. But other than that, leakage problems of compressed air does not pose significant trouble. Here, the leakage problems can be significantly higher. No matter whatever is the system condition, no matter how good working condition it is, it will always have some sort of leakage. So when you prefer clean applications, say for example, the opening and closing of doors in a shuttle bus or a transportation bus, where the driver opens the door remotely, and there you use compressed air. But where leakage problems, where leakage problems are not really significant or important, but the force requirements are very high. For example, the equipment in construction, where load carrying and the pressure capacity is significant criteria, there you should go for hydraulic systems.